Hey guys, it's March 6, 2014. I'm Reginald, also known as Dimcad. I told you guys about the Ukraine situation and how this peninsula, this Crimea peninsula, is pretty much dominated by ethnic Russians in Ukraine, right? Well, now members of the parliament in Ukraine in that peninsula are now asking Russia to allow this peninsula to join the Russian Federation, which is pretty incredible. Now, there's also reports by the BBC that in certain areas where the Russian forces actually surrounded Ukrainian missile defense, apparently they just left certain sites. But this is an interesting development right here. You actually have members of parliament for Ukraine asking Russia to allow them into, well, the Russian Federation, which is absolutely incredible. The U.S. is actually, the Pentagon is actually putting about six F-15 jets in the region, I think in Estonia, and also Latvia and Lithuania as well, just basically in that region. And it's supposed to be a response to what's going on in Ukraine. It's supposed to be at the request of those countries. We'll see how this really develops. But again, I stand by what I said before. The U.S. really needs to stay out of this situation and really needs to focus more on its problems at home. Speaking of which, the economy, mortgage applications rose. They actually rebounded recently, but a couple weeks ago, they're at their lowest level in two decades. Lowest level in two decades, mortgage applications. The ISM services index actually collapsed to somewhere around 51.6 or so. Now, this was much, much lower than their expected 53.5, okay? So what this means is that in the service sector, in the service industry, in the service sector, there's been there's still some growth because it's above 50, but it was a big, big drop there. So we'll see how this, and it's really interesting because it was the biggest drop since the Lehman Brothers event, and it hit its lowest level in about 4 years, since somewhere around March, I think it was February 2010. So that was pretty telling. As far as the retail sector, Staples, they actually they announced they're going to shut 225 stores, about 10% of what they have in North America. You also have RadioShack announcing that they're going to shut down at least 1,000 stores right here in North America. That's about 1,000 or 1,100 out of the 5,200 stores that they have right here in North America. You know, the problem with RadioShack, I don't think it's an economic issue. I think it was a strategy issue. Their problem is that they thought it would be a good idea to go all out into cell phones, but they never really dominated cell phones. Best Buy had a similar strategy. They didn't go all out, but everybody wanted to get into the cell phone selling business, and it didn't really work out for everybody. It wasn't enough of the market to really justify RadioShack focusing so much on that market. See, I think RadioShack was better off when they were a niche store, where they could actually do something that other stores couldn't do. That's what really makes stores unique. When you say, okay, I need some electronics, I need some components for electronics. RadioShack, they offered things that other people didn't have, and that's what made them unique. But when they moved away from that, they put themselves in a bad position. Anyway, women's fashion retailer Dots, based in Ohio, is going to shut about all 360 stores. They're filing for Chapter 11 bankruptcy. So there you go. Interesting science news. Actually, at Columbia University, a biophysicist actually found a way to use cells to actually create energy. They actually used bacterial spores. They actually found out they actually release a lot of energy when you rehydrate them, which is pretty awesome. They actually laid them out on some rubber, and the rubber would do like this. And it actually produced enough energy to rival a car battery, which is kind of awesome. So that's a usable energy. Here's a question. What type of renewable energies or any type of alternative energies do you think will be very important in the 21st century? I think they've yet to be developed at this point. Now, last but certainly not least, I was speaking to a healthcare professional, somebody worked in the industry. I'm not going to say his full name, but let's just say it begins with B. Okay, he knows who he is. Okay, hey man, what's up? great conversation I had with them over Skype, and he was talking about how, you know, a lot of times the poor people use emergency rooms as clinics. They come there for non-emergency reasons. And a lot of these people, their problems are stemming from hygiene. They don't really take care of themselves like they really should. And I think a lot of that has to do with children having children. When you have a lot of children, a lot of irresponsible people having kids, and they've never been taught basic things by their parents, it's very easy for them to repeat the same mistake with their own kids. You know, you have these kids being sent to the worst schools where you don't have a lot of role models. It doesn't even seem like a real school, and people, they start to view themselves as not really being important, because that's the message they're getting from the rest of society. Maybe I'm just reading too much into this, but it's interesting how a lot of people don't take care of themselves, even wash themselves in the poor areas of our society. So how do you think Obamacare is going to affect the emergency rooms across the country? Okay. Obviously, we have a lot of urgent cares that a lot of people can use, but a lot of people can't even afford them. A lot of people go to the emergency rooms because they know that the emergency rooms can't turn them down. It's the law. So share your thoughts on that. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.